This is your kapata of them all. You see, of these things I'm talking about, this is the one that pisses me off the very most. When, let's say, you're selling a top or you're selling this hair now, you put a picture up on Instagram and you now say, top, white and black top for sale, DM me for price. Are you stupid? Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Nello here again. And if you're new here, thank you so much for tuning in today. Please subscribe, guys. Subscribe. And if you're not new, thank you for coming back as always. Anyways, I'm just going to get into today's video. You guys, this video was actually inspired by a post I saw on Instagram yesterday. And this is just something I've been talking about of late with my friends and family. And I'm just like, you know what? I just come out here and say it. I should just say it because I love venting. Who doesn't love venting? So let me just vent to you guys today. So I'm just going to start from the post that annoyed me yesterday and then move on to the other things that annoy me. And these are all things that, like, these are all things that people do on Instagram, whether it's Instagram vendors or just Instagram, should I say personalities, just people on Instagram, basically, actually the ones that feel that they are important or popular or something. I'm just like, I've had it. So this is me just venting. So if you want to listen to my vent, just keep on watching. So the post yesterday that started this whole, that inspired this whole video, is a post by Nelly. Some of you might know her. I'm not even going to say, I'm not going to call names in this video because I really do not give a single F, because I mean, nobody pays my bills. Anyways, it's a post by Nelly. She posted this picture of Oba. I don't know if you guys know what Oba is. I don't even know if Oba has English name. Does Oba have English name? I don't know. I don't know if Oba has English name, but she posted a picture of an Oba picture, which is a picture that Nazom's Corner, you guys already know Nazom's Corner. I think you might not, you might, but I'm going to put her YouTube here and her Instagram. It was a picture that Nazom's Corner posted some months ago. It's her picture. She took it herself. And then Nelly's reposted this picture and, oh, hold on. I captured it. I'm just going to read what she puts. Oh, she was like, happy Sunday, blah 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 blah. Do you know the name of this? Blah blah blah. Do you think it's gluten free? Blah blah blah. Hashtag Nelly's. And then no picture credits, no photo credits. Trying to tell people or make people think that she actually took the picture, that like that picture was actually hers. And I have a problem with that, you guys. Like, I actually have a big problem with that. And then I go onto the account and I comment, please, you need to be giving photo credits. This is Nazom's Corner's picture. The least you can do is give her credit or don't use it. And then a lot of other people actually commented, give Nazom's Corner credit for her picture. People that know that that was Nazom's picture. Some people were like, in fact, even Nazom went under the picture and collected this. My upper picture has blown. No, I got this upper very early in the morning in Enugu. I wish I can visit just to eat this upper, something like that. And then till now, this happened yesterday, so 24 hours later, there's still no picture credit on that picture. And I don't know about you guys, but I just feel like it's very, very deceiving. You're trying to get a conversation started on your page. You're trying to get people to comment. You're trying to get people to like your picture. You're trying to get new followers, but you're not giving credit to the person you're using their original content. I don't know, but it just pisses me off so much, because this is not the first time people are doing this to Nazom. Nazom is my sister. I don't know if you guys know. Maybe that is why my anger is on another level. She's working so hard, taking these pictures, cooking these meals, just to put it out on Instagram, you know, and just grow her page, grow her business. Maybe Nazom is my sister, that's why I'm this angry. But it's annoying, you guys. I see a lot of Instagram accounts just deceiving people with pictures that are not their pictures, especially all these weight loss people and all these foodie people. They never post pictures of their actual food. They keep reposting food days. Food days have suffered on Instagram. Like, food days, you guys already know food days. Food days have suffered. Food days, Niger foodie, those two people, I know they have suffered. I even comment, like, I take it personal. I always comment, please give picture credit to Food Ace or Niger Foodie or somebody, because I feel like those people put in a lot of work to cook that food, take those pictures, make it fine to grow, like to put out content for people to see and to grow their business, because most of these people do this for a living. You guys already know I'm on a Niger Foodie plan, which I can't say I'm, you know, following right now, but but anyways, you know, they actually put in so much work for these things, and it pisses me off when people don't give them at least the very least you can do is give credit, you know. Which brings me to my second point, which is actually taking permission before putting up people's pictures. In this case, not necessarily a food picture. I know I've had this problem. Me and my family, Nazom and some people in my family, we've had this picture with this problem, I mean to say, with you know, some people on Instagram. They go on Instagram, and let's say I put Kobe's picture down on Instagram, and somebody that sells baby things just goes ahead, reposts Kobe's picture on their page, and says things like, you can buy this top from us, blah, blah, blah. Sister, first of all, I did not buy the top from you. I didn't. Secondly, this is my child's picture, and I want to believe that you should have the decency to actually ask me, can I use your baby's picture to do this or to do this? Because it's different if I actually bought the top from you. For example, if I buy a top from somebody on Instagram and I be like, oh, Kobe rocking a top from this account, that means automatically, even though you're not taking permission, I tag the meaning I want you to see it, meaning for me or in my own case, meaning I'm okay for you to use it. Because whenever I tag an account on Instagram, it's usually because maybe I'm okay with them reposting, or I want them to see how I use what I bought from them, or something like, you know, that kind of thing. But the situation where I don't tag you, you don't know me, I don't know you, just carry my child's picture and repost, I use my child to sell your product. I have a problem with that. You are not paying me for that. So please don't do it. Please do not do it. It's annoying. I actually find it very, very annoying. It won't take you a lot to just DM me. Be like, hey, Nello, please, can I use your son's picture on my page for this? The picture looks so nice. Sincerely, I can't even say no. I'm putting out my son on social media because I'm okay with it. So I'm okay. Like, people probably like screenshot the picture, do whatever they want with the picture, because I put it out there, it's fine. But if I'm going to repost my picture and use it to sell your product or use it for something that serious, you should at least take permission. That's actually the very least you can do. The next point is this is your patapata of them all. You see, of these things I'm talking about, this is the one that pisses me off the very most. When, let's say, you're selling a top or you're selling this hair now, you put the picture up on Instagram and you now say, top, white and black top for sale, DM me for price. Are you stupid? Why do I have to DM you for the price? Literally, I'm trying not to vent as much as I vent to the people around me. This is me, like, really containing my vents. This is not me even venting to the fullest, but it's annoying. Why do I have to DM you for the price? Do you realize that you make sales difficult? And I see a lot of people complain about this particular problem on Instagram. You make sales difficult for you. You're actually chasing customers away. For example, I'm selling backdrops, which some of you might know, some of you might not know, but I know that under every picture, I put the size of the backdrop, the price, the just details about the backdrop, what you can use for, what you cannot use for, things like that, which is basic. Even though I still get a lot of people DMing me, how much is it, this, that. It's a tiny bit annoying, let me not even lie, but it's still okay. But the one I don't like is I want to buy a top, and you just go and you put DM me for price. Why do I have to DM you for price? Why can't you just put the price under the top so that by the time I enter your DM, it will be that I actually want to buy the product? Why do you have to put me through the stress of DMing you, and at the end of the day, you now tell me the top, like this tank top I'm wearing now, is 20,000 and I'm not interested? And that's how disturbing means. I've had cases that the next week they'll not message you, I didn't hear back from you again. You can send the money to social account. Sister, I do not want to buy it anymore because it's expensive. You would have saved yourself that stress and saved me this whole process if you just put the price of the top under the picture of the top. You guys, it is very simple. And another thing is that even myself, this one, I have tried it by myself. I actually tried this thing recently. I see a top or an item on Instagram and I go in with my Nello OKK account and I'll be like, how much is this top? The person will say 10,000 naira. It's fine. I just reply, okay, because I mean, I cannot buy this top for 10,000 naira. Your girl is not that rich yet. And then going with another person's account or my, I have several accounts depending on, you know, the business. Anyways, I go with another account and then I ask, how much is this top? And the person goes, 7,000 naira. In fact, I actually have a friend that did that to me recently. Okay, this one is different because I actually entered the shop and I'm like, how much for this? And she says, 5,000. And then I bought it 5,000. And then the next day, I go on Instagram and, you know, I'm looking at pictures on her page. And then I see that particular product and I open the picture and someone under the picture asked her how much, and then she goes 4,000. I was pissed off, you guys. Like, it's annoying. Which is something people do when they don't put the price under their product. They now have the right to tell you different prices when you enter their DM. Why do you have to do that? You're not even helping your business. Like, it's not nice. Because one way or the other, eventually, the truth is going to come out. You're not helping your business. Putting it under, you just know that anybody that comes to your DM is actually coming to purchase the item or coming to know more about the item because they're actually okay with the price that you've put out. But in a situation where you don't put out price and I have to go all the way to your DM, which at the end of the day, you guys, I don't even do it anymore. If you're one of those that write DM for price, I don't. It's different if you're selling car or plane or something that maybe you don't have on ground and you help people to pre-order and stuff. I think I might be okay with that. But in a situation that you're selling freaking top, you guys, slippers, shoe, bag, you know the price you're selling. Just put it under your picture and save all the stress. And save yourself the stress as well, okay? Moving on to my next point. All those people that like these fake pictures to attract followers, where are you now? Where have you reached? Where have you flown to? All those people that they're selling clothes to, or they're selling hair, or they're selling shoe, they will now, for example, when you get things from AliExpress or Amazon or anywhere, sometimes the pictures are very deceiving. And then you put out the picture on Instagram and you receive the item and you can clearly see that this item you received is very different from the picture of the item. I get they've deceived you into buying it using the picture, but you can actually save other people that stress and that heartbreak. Like, it's actually wicked of you to make other people feel the way you felt. For example, there's something I bought and then I put a picture for pre-order and some people actually pre-ordered for that item. And then when it got to me, I realized that it was a lot smaller than what I actually thought. It was a lot smaller than the picture that they had on their website. So anybody that was interested, because I already put it up, I couldn't just take it down. But anybody that showed interest in that picture, I just go ahead and I tell them, see you, this item in this picture is this big, but what I received is this small. And even though I've already priced it according to how much I bought it, I actually lost money, because when you don't tell people it's this small, let's say you're selling a big one 4,000, they don't expect you to sell a small one 4,000 as well. So at the end of the day, I ended up selling it a little bit less than I bought it, but at least I could sleep well at night because I was sincere. I have a problem with that, especially people that sell makeup and some things. Like, they put up a picture of contour. I bought some contour things on Instagram recently. This picture looked very dark. You would think that this thing can actually contour a dark person. And then when I got the contour, it was like my powder. In fact, almost lighter than my powder. And this kind of thing has happened to me before when I wanted to buy makeup. So I just felt like it could have been nice if that person told me, okay, what do you want to use this for? Do you want to use that powder or contour? Because it's not dark enough for contour or something. That's something I would do for somebody. So I'm probably expecting too much, thinking somebody should do it for me. But it's just the right thing to do. You guys, stop deceiving people. Because the person that sold that thing to me, I'm never patronizing that person ever again. Because you actually knew that the picture is not as dark as, like the product, I mean, it's not as dark as the picture you put up. And you just sold it to me as if is that dark, as if it looks exactly like what you put up. I have a problem with that. I really have a problem with that. You guys, you need to just be more sincere, more open, and just help each other out. You guys, if I'm happy with your service, I'm most likely going to come return and buy something from you again. It's just how life is. But in a situation where you lie, you've lost me for life. You have lost me for life, and all the other people I might have attracted or brought to your page, you've lost all that. In your mind, you think you're making sales, but you sell to one person once, that person never buys from you again. Are you really growing? I don't even, if that's how you can't grow, then you don't even know what you're doing your business. Because returning customers are actually the most important customers that trust your business, love your business, love what you have to offer, and just keep coming back. They're the ones that spend most if you really do the best and think about it. This is the last point I wrote down. All these people, especially fitness people, you guys, fitness people that will come on Instagram. First of all, we did not know you when you were big, oh, we didn't. On Instagram, we just know that you came the way you are. This is how you've been uploading pictures, and then you are claiming fitness coach. You are charging people 50,000 naira for 2 weeks of coaching them to lose weight. What are you coaching? See, that is why I love Naija Food that I use, you guys. I don't even know this person personally. She's not related to me in any way. I don't know anything about her. But I just feel like her plan is so realistic and actually affordable for what she offers. Because before I ended up with Naija Foodie, after I had my baby, do you know how many people I DM'd on Instagram? Let me not even call their names yourself. I've DM'd a lot of people. They tell me, oh, to do this is 50,000. 50,000, you're not giving me, what's it called? Recipes. You're not giving me a lot. You're just coaching me online how to lose weight. What are you coaching? First of all, you claim you were fat. I don't know you when you were fat. And I'm saying it because I actually have a friend. I have a friend who was this big. And then she went on and did gastric bypass or something. One of those gastric things. And then she lost a lot of weight. And then on Instagram now, she's slaying. And then when people are like, oh, what did you do to lose weight? She says things like, oh, I went on low carbs, I exercise, I go to the gym. what is that? Why do you feel like you have to lie? So that's why I don't really trust all this like fitness coaches and people that claim fitness, because I don't know what you did to actually lose that weight. You're just, because you were big and you're slim now, you're coming to sell it to me, and you're not selling the ridiculous prices that I don't even know what I'm going to gain from you if I actually buy that. And then if you notice something about all those fitness pages, they never post original content. It's either they keep posting quotes, or they'll, once in a blue moon they post before and after. Only God knows if that before and after is actually their before and after, because I don't know those other people. I don't know, I can't confirm this story, but you don't know if it's a before and after. They are saying they are fitness people, they are dietitians, on their all this, all that. They never post food that they cook in their family. Somebody like Food Ace, for example, a Niger foodie, bless them. Because Food Ace, oh my God, looking at her pictures, I just want to marry her, in fact. The same goes to Niger foodie. You actually know that they cook those pictures, they take out time to create those contents. And then some other people goes ahead and they take pictures from people that have worked hard and put it on their page and say, you can lose weight eating this, DM me for info. Why? Like, you guys, a lot of things that happen on Instagram that we need to stop. I'm just going to end this rant here, because if I keep going, it's a lot, and I don't have all the time in the world. So I'm just going to end it here. You guys, you Instagram vendors, you Instagram people, you guys need to stop it. Just stop it. Be sincere to yourself, be sincere to your followers, be sincere to your customers. It doesn't cost a thing, and it's only good for your business in the long run. Anyways, if you guys have encountered any of these problems, please let me know in the comment section. Let's have a discussion. Let's all talk about this, because you guys already know I like to discuss with you guys in the comment section. Just leave your comment down below. And at this point, you've watched this video from the very start of this video to the end, to this point, and you're not still subscribed to my channel, I don't even think you're loyal. You're not loyal. You're one of those people we're talking about here. So just go ahead and subscribe. Subscribe. It doesn't cost a thing. It does not cost a thing. Okay? Thank you guys so much for watching. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.